Hello students, today I am going to take another lecture for the GPRS. This is the concluding part of the GPRS in which we have studied, in which we will learn about the architecture and applications of GPRS. So first of all, see the GPRS network architecture, which consists of several terms which I will discuss in the next page. So here that we have already learned the GSM, and that is indicated here how GSM is connected with GPRS, mobile station, base station subsystems, network and switching subsystem, operating subsystem, HLR, home location register, authentication center, everything which we have already seen. And in the next page I am giving you the name of this is the GPRS network architecture, which shows the basic connection between the internal elements. Now come to the second page. The various network elements are given as ME means mobile equipment, BTS means base transceiver station, BSC means base station controller, MSC means mobile switching center, SGSN means serving GPRS support node, GGSN, Gateway GPRS Support Node, OMC, Operation and Maintenance Center, HLR, Home Location Register, AUC, Authentication Center, GR, GPRS Register, EIR, Equipment Identity, Identity Register, SMSC, Short Message Service Center. When a voice or data communication request is originated from mobile equipment, it is transported over the air interface to BTS, from BTS to BSC in the same way as a standard GSM call. GPRS register used to manage information related to each GPRS subscriber as well as routing information. Now see the next step, that is the GPRS protocol stack. This is the GPRS protocol stack, where it shows the protocol stack with end-to-end message flows from the mobile center, mobile station to the GPRS GSM. It can be observed that the application communicates via a standard IP and is carried through GPRS network and out to PDN through the gateway. So we can say that GPRS network looks like a normal sub network to users both inside and outside the network. Protocol between GGSN and SGSN is GPRS tunneling protocol GTP between SGSN and MS, combination of sub network dependent convergence protocol. Logic link control is used. SNDCP compresses data to minimize the load on the radio channel, and LCC provides a safe logical link by encrypting packets. Now we come to the last part of GPRS, that is application of GPRS. We can use it in chat, information services as text or graphics, still images, moving images, web browsing, document sharing and remote collaborative working, audio reports, job dispatch, corporate email, LAN applications, internet email, vehicle positioning, file transfer, etc. To use GPRS applications, the user requires a mobile phone or terminal that supports GPRS, a subscription to a mobile telephone network that supports GPRS, and knowledge of how to send or receive information through GPRS. Thank you.